In this video, I'm just going to show you how to retouch your photos in less than 10 minutes using the frequency separation technique. So before we start, if you're new on this channel, my name is Eustace, and if you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe and smash that bell icon so that when I put up my next video, you will be notified. So we said less than 10 minutes, so let's put a countdown on the screen. So let's make the frequency separation layers. I'm going to go down on this background layer. I'm going to make two copies of this background layer, Control J on the keyboard. So I'm going to Control J1, then Control J2. The first one, I'm going to name it color. The second one, I'm going to name it texture. Okay, so this is our texture layer and this is our color layer. So I'm going to disable our texture layer. I'm going to click on this eyeball and then I'm going to select the color layer. And then I'm going to go to filter and then I'll select noise and then I'll select dust and scratches. So by default, the radius is one. So what I want to subtract or to remove the textures from the color layer. So I'm going to select the place or the area in the photo that has a lot of textures. Let me select this part right here. So I'm going to increase the radius value to 10. So this radius value is not automatic, like every time you're supposed to use the radius value of 10. So this radius value will go according to the textures that are in the photos that you are working on. So in my case, the radius of 10 is fine. I don't want to go overboard. I don't want a skin to be like that. I want to remove the textures, but I can still see the features of her face. 10. And then I'm going to click OK. The next thing that I'm going to do, I'm going to go to the texture layer and then I'm going to enable it here. So we are going to go to image and then we are going to select apply image. So by default, here on the layer, it's on merged. The channel RGB and then blending option is on multiply. So we are going to change these settings. So on the layer here, we are going to select the color layer, the one that we made, which is here. It's the one that we are going to select. We are going to put it here. And then on the RGB, we are going to leave it the way it is. The blending option here, I'll change it to subtract because I'm subtracting the colors from the texture. So I'm going to select subtract. And then scale, I'll set the scale to the maximum, and the maximum value of the scale is 2. I want to remove all the colors from the textures layer. So I'm going to set my offset to gray, 50% gray. That's 128. So you can see all the colors are gone. Like, we don't have the colors in this layer. We only have the textures of a skin. So I'm going to click OK. And then I'm going to go to blending option here. And then I'm going to select linear light. So we are going to put these adjustments into a group. I'm going to select the texture layer. And then I'm going to alt control. And then I'll select the color layer. And then I'm going to alt control plus G on the keyboard to put them into a group. So we will name this group as frequency separation. And then we're going to place enter on the keyboard. So these are before, these are after. If I disable this, I'm supposed to see the original photo. If I enable it, I'm supposed to see the original photo. Now let's proceed with our retouching. I'm going to open our group here, and then I'm going to select the color layer. And then I'm going to go on my tools here, and then I'm going to select the lasso tool. So what I want, if I make a selection like this, I don't want whatever I'm going to apply to this selection just to be limited to this selection. I want it to go further. I want it to go outside the selection, just a little bit outside this selection. Let me deselect this. So I'm going to go to further here, and then I'm going to change it to 20 pixels because I want, when I make a selection like this, whatever I'm going to do to be 20 pixels outside my selection. So I'm going to select this part. So when doing the selection, don't just select like this, or you select like this, or you select like that. So select according to the shape. Like, let me make a selection. Like, I'm going to select I'm going to select this according to where it's going. Like, I'm going to select it like the way it is up to somewhere here, and then I'm going to go back and then I'll join it here. And then I'm going to go to filters, and then I'm going to select blur, and then I'm going to select Gaussian blur. So do you remember when we were working on the color layer, let me just go back just a bit, when we went on filter and then we selected noise and then we selected the dust and scratches, we had a radius of 10. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to apply the blur. That's 3 times our radius. If you went for the radius of 5, make the blur 3 times the radius of 5. So let's do that. And I'm going to go to filter, and then I'm going to select blur, and then I'm going to select Gaussian blur. So I'm going to go 3 times the radius of 10 pixels. So I'm going to go with the radius of 30. So I'm going to enter 30 here. So you can see it's changing here. Then I'm going to click OK. So I'm going to select this part. Then I'm going to go back to filter, and then blur, and then Gaussian blur. And then I'm going to go with the radius of 30. I'm going to click OK. So I'm going to select this part, select it like this. So instead of going back to filter, blur, and then Gaussian blur, I'm going to go to filter, and then just on top here, you see the shortcut to the same process that we did. It's Alt plus Control plus F. So I'm just going to do Control plus Alt plus F. So I'm going to select this part, Control plus Alt plus F. Here on the nose, I'm going to change the radius to a smaller number. I don't want the radius of 30. Let me show you. If I go to filter, I select blur, and then I select Gaussian blur. These are before, these are after. Like, the nose is now flat. I don't want a nose to be flat. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to reduce the radius to 0.1, and then I'll start pushing it up. Let's say maybe 15. Then I'm going to click OK. So this is our before, this is our after. So I'm going to deselect this. Light click and then deselect. So what we are going to do now, we are just going to remove the blemishes. We are going to remove the pimples. So I'm going to go to our frequency separation folder, and then I'm going to open it, and then I'm going to select the texture, and then I'm going to go to my tools here, and then I'm going to select the clone stamp tool. So I'm going to make the brush bigger than the pimple or the blemish that I want to remove. So I want to remove this pimple here. I don't know if you can see it. So I'll make this brush bigger than this pimple. So I'm going to add Alt to sample. So I want to sample this part, and then I'll paint it on the pimple. So set the sample here to current. Don't set it to current and below or all layers. Then I'm going to go down here. I want to remove this. So I'm going to select this part. I'm going to add Alt on the keyboard, and then I'll sample this part, and then I'll paint there. I'll sample even this part, and then I'll paint there. I'll sample this part, then I'll paint the pimple. So I want to remove this. I'm going to sample here. Then I'm going to paint like that. I'm going to sample here. Then I'm going to paint like that. If you want to learn how to remove the blemishes, I do have a video on this channel. I'll put it in the description. You can just go and watch it. Then I'll sample here. Then I'll paint. Then I'll sample. So I'm going to sample here. Then I'll clean like that, and then I'll sample even this part, and then I'll clean it like that. This is our before, this is our after. So the next thing that I'm going to do, I'm going to do the teeth and eye whitening. I'm going to whitening the teeth and the eyes. I have a video about teeth and eye whitening. I'll put it in the description. You can just watch it. I'm going to use my actions to do the teeth and eye whitening. I'll put the link in the description. You can just go in the description and download it and use it. So I'm going to go to my actions, and then I'm going to select the teeth and eye whitening. I'm going to select this, and then I'm going to go to this teeth and eye whitening folder. I'm going to open it, and then I'm going to select the photo filter adjustment here. I'm going to select the brush, and then my opacity is at 100%, flow is at 100%. Since the layer mask here is black, I'll set the foreground color to white, so that when I paint white on a black layer mask, it's going to show us the effect. So I'm going to make the brush a little bit smaller and then I'll paint here. I don't want to whitening the eyes and the teeth on one layer. I'm going to run another teeth and eye whitening. I'm going to go to my actions and then teeth and eye whitening folder. I'm going to open it and then I'm going to whitening the teeth. So I'm going to zoom it in. I'm going to whitening the teeth now. So this is our before, this is our after. That's how you can retouch your photos using the frequency separation technique. So if you want to retouch fast and level up your retouching skills, you should check out my retouching actions pack. I'll see you in the next one.
Peace.